What's up, guys? It's Brian from Hash for Hub. It's about 9:54 p.m. Eastern Time, March 26, 2018. And we got a brand new trading video coming to you on Bitcoin. But first, before we get on into it, if you're new to us, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, because we got lots of TA going on over here. Crypto TA, to be specific. And if you're interested in that, we definitely would appreciate you subscribing to us. If you're on if you're on DTube or Steemit, we would love, obviously, for you to subscribe there as well. And an upvote or resteam would be greatly appreciated. So let's get right into it. I think where we left off last, we were sitting right about this level right here, which is about 81.20, somewhere right around here where we had this sell-off. And believe it or not, I drew a few lines since then, which I'll go over in a minute here. We basically nailed where the bottom of this is right now. The question becomes, is this the end of the five waves, end of the five waves coming down? And what we're thinking is, and I'm going to show you how we kind of call this bottom, at least an intermediate bottom, is by doing this right here, okay? Where we thought that this is the top of the third wave, this is the bottom of the third wave right here, okay? And then we normally what we look for, and again, this is conservative extensions, where, you know, you look for the third wave to be a one-to-one extension with respect to the first wave, and that the fifth wave, what we like to see is actually the fifth wave to make it to about 1.618. But as I mentioned, more times than not, it makes it somewhere between, basically right on the halfway mark between 1 and 1.618, which is basically exactly where we are right here. Basically tagged the bottom nearly to the penny. So at least an intermediate bottom. Now the question becomes, is this five waves coming down? It can be counted as the way in which I counted it, where we have this one wave, two, you know, three, four, and a five. And remember, based on Elliott Wave's rule of, the name escapes me right now. Alternation, I think that's what it is. Sorry about that. I totally forgot. I've only mentioned it a million times over the past few weeks. For some reason, I don't remember the name right now. But if the second wave is kind of like a complex correction, then the fourth wave normally won't be, and vice versa, okay? And so that's kind of what we see here. The second wave is this kind of complex correction, and the fourth wave is almost nothing. Now, this could be it, or this could be the one wave, this could be two, and down here is the third wave, where this is the fourth wave, and then we're going to have a fifth wave coming down. That very well could be the case. I'm kind of 50-50 as to whether or not this is the five waves coming down. What I did like to see is that the fact that there was a lot of volume coming in, and on top of it, we also see a lot of price movement on that volume. Look what we saw here. We think we mentioned this the last video or two videos ago. Look at all this volume that came in right here, but then the candle did almost nothing, right? Did very, very little. Here we have less volume, right? And look at how much the candle did, right? This volume right here took us all the way back up to the green line where we stopped, and it also happens to be our one hour resistance line of 8,183. Where yes, the wicks have gone through, but look at the bodies. The bodies basically stopped right there. I mean, this is crazy. Reminds me of like birds sitting on a power line. I mean, they were all just like lined up perfectly here. So, I mean, another thing I want to mention here is, so everyone always asks, well, you know, Elliott Wave Theory, what in the world is it useful for? Well, exactly just this, right? So if you didn't know how to count waves, right, and you didn't know that we were looking at some sort of ABC structure, right? You didn't know, if you didn't know any of these things, right, but you knew enough to draw a channel right here, right? You would see this right here and you'd be like, oh my God, the freaking sky's falling, right? I mean, that's kind of like what new traders do, especially traders that are not in the Elliott wave, theory mindset, okay? And you would have to start looking at your RSIs, RSI Laguerre's, if you do what we do. You know, some people use stochastics, some people use, you know, unbalanced volume. You know, people use all sorts of different things that are out there, right? I can make a video, 1,000 hours long on every single thing that everybody uses, right? So, you know, Elliott Wave Theory tells us is that, you know, hey, this right here, when we were standing right here, we were saying we're expecting another wave down. Okay, yeah, we were expecting it. Wow, this is selling off. My gosh, that's crazy. Okay, cool. What were we looking for? We were expecting another wave down. So when the market goes down and you're expecting another wave, you're not like, oh my God, you know, with the freaking, you know, the sky's falling, right? And if you knew something about, if you didn't know something about Elliott Wave Theory and you just looked at this channel right here, again, you may be fooled, right? This is what they call a bear trap, okay? Some bears may be looking for this channel breakout, right? And then they would go short it, and then look what happened. Boom. Now, this is how institutions make money, boys and girls. or ladies and gentlemen. Because if you're trading, you're not a boy and girl, I imagine. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is how institutions make money. This is how big money pushes prices. They know people are looking at this type of stuff, right? They know people, or at least the newbies, are looking at these channels and stuff like that. And they push it down. They push it down quite a bit. And then they see how much they can go ahead and pick up down here. And then they just freaking load up the truck. They back up the truck and just say, give me as much as possible. And that's exactly what looks like it's happening right here. Because then, what did it do? They basically all just started selling right here. Let's see if this is even some sort of a Fibonacci, retracement level. I don't even know. Let's go ahead and take a look. Yeah, it tried to make it to the 0.382, and then it stopped basically halfway. So nothing too decisive as far as Elliott Wave Theory is concerned. But it pretty decisive with regards to my 1 hour resistance magic over here, as some people call it. So can we make another wave down? Yes, absolutely. We totally can. Totally can. Am I very confident about it? No. I was much more confident about this wave coming down to make a fifth wave than I am that this is, you know, the fourth wave and we're going to make a fifth wave down. Anyways, you know, it doesn't really make too much of a difference to me as far as what I'm trading right now. So I'm not looking to go ahead and get in to capture the last, you know, few dollars of the fifth wave, you know, coming down. Okay. I mean, it can be, but I'm just not interested right now in doing it. I have a bunch of other things on as far as trades. So we had the C. We're thinking maybe it would kind of, you know, originally a few videos ago, we were thinking it was going to kind of come down to this level right around here. I've called it about 8,050. Obviously, it's come down lower to about 7,826. Regardless, I think it was pretty good. I think we called that a long time ago. So yeah, next, what are we really looking for? We are looking for, next. So we made this bottom right here. And so I said, you know something, maybe this is a wedge. This kind of looks pretty wedge-like. And so I just drew this line right here. I drew this top line right here, which is basically very parallel with this parallel channel. Okay. And now I'm looking for some sort of a wedge formation. All right. So, I mean, you can kind of say this is like, you know, the A, the B, the C, the D, the E, and then maybe we go up. That could be it, and maybe that E gives us the fifth leg. That's definitely something that is totally doable. But the kind of real important thing is not only is that the 1 hour resistance level is right here, but we also have this 1 hour resistance level intersected the top of this green line. And, you know, I'll be 100% honest as I am with everything. I'm surprised that this thing has gotten rejected so hard off of this 1 hour resistance and this green line, which again tells me a lot about sentiment that there really aren't any really big bulls here, you know, really willing to move this thing up. And that clearly doesn't make me happy, obviously. I mean, you know, in the end, I may be very, very bearish. But in the end, yeah, I'm still an optimist. I'm still human. I still want to see this thing go up. So, yeah, so just keep an eye on this wedge right here. But what are we also thinking about, okay? And I'm going to show you right here real quick. A, B, C. Okay, somewhere around here. Somewhere around this 96, 9700 level. So who cares, right? Well, I'll tell you why. Because if this is an ABC going in this direction, then this is the primary direction of the market, down. And we're making a corrective wave up, only to go down again. All right? So what do we need to look for? We need to look for what does this motive wave look like? If this is the end of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Right? If this is the end of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coming down right here, right? Then we need to make sure that the wave, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coming up makes a small correction and then continues to go up, right? Because another way you can look at this is we have a flat. We have a 5. A 3 and a 5, because this 3 right here is just a smaller, you know, ABC, right? 5 waves down, 3 waves up, 5 waves down. All right, guys? So, doesn't keep me up at night. Not really much does these days. But it is something that clearly you need to understand. So again, why is Elliott wave theory good? Because it tells you stuff like that. It gives you potential roadmaps, right? So when we run back up here and we say, okay, we got 5 waves. Now what, guys? Now let's take a look and really look at see what happens with this correction, because maybe it's going to tell us what's going to happen kind of in the future coming back down. All right, so let's look at some resistance level. The 1 hour resistance level is basically gone, but I'm just going to keep it here. Keep it here like a trophy. No, I'm joking. Just keep it here because I just want to, you know, I think it's going to come back and play again, really, as many of them before in the past has. The 4 hour resistance is 8,416. Now, remember when I was making the video earlier today, I had gone ahead and I said, well, the candle has not closed just yet, that 4 hour candle, so this very well could change, okay? So 8,416, and that makes sense where that is, okay? I mean, there's a lot of resistance level right here, all right? Next, the daily resistance. The daily resistance is 8,861. Okay, now this is with a caveat. Right now it's 9,665. Okay, however, remember before I was saying the candle is open, right? The daily candle is open. Well, the daily candle has actually closed, but it closed in such a manner where I'm not changing the resistance level. But based on where we are right now from the day's candle that's just opened up a few hours ago, if it were to close here, I would close the daily resistance or change the daily resistance to 8,861. A lot of people have asked how I go about this. I'm trying to figure out how to disseminate it most accurately and easily digestible. But it's just from years and years of just staring at this shit. Yeah, that's really what it's about. It's just years and years of staring at this stuff. There are algorithms that are behind this, no question. Not at a point yet that I want to share all this stuff just yet. Trying to figure out a better way to kind of package it up and stuff like that. So, I think that is really about it for right now. Not really going to go over much of this, you know, RSI stuff. Oh, maybe I will real quick. Sorry. So this is on a 1 hour basis. We have, you know, this trend line right here. It would peaked above it. You know, maybe we're going to come back down again. Laguerre RSI, I mean, Laguerre RSI is worth its weight in gold. And not sure how much an algorithm weighs in gold, but it would be quite a bit if you're trading Bitcoin. I mean, right here, look at this, right? Look how it called basically this top right here. And you would have been able to ride it all the way down to the bottom to where we got this candle coming right up here. So, you can go back in time. You'll see it's on pretty well. And that's just it by itself. I mean, you can do a lot of things to make it better. Anyway, so, I think we're going to leave it there for right now because my eyes are kind of crossing. And have a great night, guys. Happy trading.